the mind before you can bestow the blessing, because until they get their mind right, everything you invest in them is going to leap out of the crevices of a mind that refuses to change. Look at your neighbor and ask him, do you have a mind to change? Wait for an answer. If they said no, drag them to the altar.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is Thursday night on the Tim A. Radio Show. I'm your host, Minister Ackridge, and we're just so excited about tonight. And we're just so happy to be back on the air live in the beautiful city of Lewisburg, North Carolina, 28 miles north of Raleigh. Tonight we got a special guest. We welcome back tonight Mr. Clifton is running for County Commissioner District number one. That's right, County Commissioner District number one. And we're going to bring him shortly after this song. So I want you to stay tuned and enjoy tonight's broadcast. It's time for a change, and we need to vote for that change. So we're going to bring him up, and we'll be right back.
All confusion, all blaming other people for your mistake. You got till midnight to get rid of every poison that's hindering you, every inflexibility that's stopping you from what God is about to pour into your life. Woe be unto you if you go into another year and waste another year with the old mentality while somebody's in the hospital begging God for the opportunity that you have right now. You better step into this moment.
Hey, 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 ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys for tuning in tonight. Those that missed it, we want to thank you, you and you. We welcome you all for listening in tonight, Thursday night on the show. We're just so happy, amen, about what's going to take place in the upcoming weeks. And I just want to let the listeners know, for those that didn't tune in to the last broadcast, we have tonight Mr. Johnny Clifton of Lewisburg running for County Commissioner District number one. And tonight he's here, and we just thank you. Brother Clifton, how you doing tonight?
Just fine, my man. I'm doing just fine.
Good, good, good. First of all, I want to say thank you for coming back on the show again. And thank you so much for taking time out your busy schedule just to come and talk to the listeners about where we are thus far in the election. So we want to know right now, how is your campaign going right now?
We're doing very well. I think everything is about where it's set. We're just working, and you know, we're trying to get some serious work done, and you know, now we're in the short road, so we just want each and every one to know that, you know, this is yet to come. We just need you just to go out to the polls. You know, the polls get ready to open on March the 3rd through March the 12th for early voting. And so we need your vote. Everybody vote is very, very important. So we need you just to you know, go to the polls. If you know a friend that's already registered, you know, call them. Let them know that their vote is very important. We need that vote in order to move forward in Franklin County.
That's right. That's right. We do need it. We have the same old mentality for the same years that pass, and we just thankful that we got some people in place now that's running that have some ideas for the growth of the county, and also especially in District 1, I feel that along with a lot of people that I talk with, they won't change, and they're just tired of the same old direction that they've been going for the past years with the current county commissioners that have been in the seat. A lot of the citizens of Franklin County have concerns on why we don't have our hospital. I read something on Facebook about, they said that the commissioners, it wasn't their fault, but in an aspect of that, one of their jobs is for health, welfare, health for the community. So they do impact, and they do play a role. County commissioners play a vital role, and if they someone else has bought the hospital and they moved, and it's now the responsibility for the county commissioner to come together, because that's one of their duties, is for health wellness of the county. And if we don't have a hospital to go to when we have a drastic emergency, what are we going to do? So,
Nancy, you're right. You're finding county commissioners, you have a lot to do with what goes on in and around the county. And, there's a lot of going around trying to set the record straight, but the record speaks for itself. Right now, we don't need a record. We need a door open at the hospital. We also need an urgent care or some type of facility for our, our elders, but we all need that. And it's the same thing for your job opportunity. We all need jobs. Franklin County is growing by leaps and bounds, but it can't progress like that if we don't offer some kind of economy in there, so we can keep people in the area and stay in the area. And right now, you got people that fled the hospital, transported people from Raleigh to Durham to Henderson to Nash, and it's really, it's getting very, very kind of touchy now, because it's good we haven't had a catastrophe, because someone losing life behind that. When you call your emergency squad out and they ain't somewhere else, and you got to wait 10 or 20 minutes for that to come, and it's not only our hospital, but our fire department. It's the same way. If you have a fire, we got to have an EMS with that fire department. And if someone got smoke damage out there, it just really is kind of a touchy. And there's so many things that happen to you. It could be your family. It could be a member of your family, not just my family or somebody we don't know. It could be someone that it could be in your household. So we definitely need our hospital back in Santa. And we didn't just only lose the hospital. I mean, you think of all the people in Franklin County that lost their jobs, guys. I mean, we need help now. And if we don't get it now, when we would get it? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I guess a lot of our commissioners or whatever now is sitting on hold trying to wait till the election is over. But right now, we need something now, not tomorrow. We need something now to get started.
Right, and that's so true. Talking with people that's moved out of Franklin County, and they feel the same. Even though they live in Wake County, some of them, they keep a tab on what's going on in Franklin County, and they just say it's nobody there. And they got to the point that they were even fed up with the way that things were going in the leadership in the county, because the county commissioner are some of the leaders in the county to make the decisions for the people and citizens of the county. And so you made a great point of people need jobs. We are growing as in people. The families are getting bigger. More people are here, but they are leaving because there's no job opportunity. And I feel strongly that if I'm a leader in the area, county commissioner, I want to go out and seek these companies that have warehouses, and they have products that they have. They can build warehouses or factories, assembly lines. They need something besides fast food. That fast food is good, but we need some people that, like yourself and some of the other ones that are running, a new face, a new idea, a new mind that's going to run and hear the people and work with the people. Because if we work together, we can move mountains. But if we working against each other, that never get done.
That's right. And that's why my main goal is working. A lot of people say, well, District 1. Well, District 1 is the district I'm running in. But once you're elected, you're in Franklin County. You're a Franklin County commissioner. And that is for one for all. And that's what it's all about. I'll be one to talk. We'll listen to your concern. Listen to your issue. And try to resolve some of your concerns and your issues. But, if you can't listen to your Franklin County, your citizen, then you don't have a chance. Your citizens don't have a chance. I mean, you got so many different things that's coming our way. And we got plenty of room in Lewisburg. We got plenty of buildings in Lewisburg. And really and truly, back to your health care, do you know that some of our nursing facilities right now are getting close to the edge of closing down? Because when someone gets sick, some of our elders get sick in the nursing center, they're moving them from to wherever they go. It may be Durham, it may be Raleigh, but they're moving out. But what I'm gathering now, we're on our, and one of our nursing centers, we have less than 40 beds. So that means that if it gets lesser and lesser, that means that the people that work in there, and that facility will be closing down. And so then your hospital closing, we already have one of our other nursing centers that's closed, already closed in Lewisburg. We got our doctor's office closed in Lewisburg. But what else? We don't have too much more left, man.
Right, you're so right. And while you was talking, I just can't help but to say that, you know, a lot of times they want to point the finger at each other. The current ones there, they dropped the ball. I'm going to let the listeners know they dropped the ball, because even though another company purchased the hospital and they moved away, but where was the strategy plan? Okay, we don't have a hospital, but where was the strategy plan created by the current seat holders of the commissioners now? Where was the strategy that, okay, now we found out the hospital is leaving. What's our strategy? Have we come together to figure out what we're going to do? Let's tell the people. Let's go to the newspaper. We don't, the current company moved away. This is, as a county commissioner, this is what we decided to do for our citizens. And that had not taken place. I have not read in the newspaper where they come together to come with an action plan. Now, we just had some major storms here just the other day, and we just thank God that we were saved by it going past us. But what if we were the ones that had disaster and we didn't have any hospitals, or all of the EMS were tied up? At least somebody can drive somebody, your neighbor, to Franklin County Regional. You can get there and they could at least help you until you either life flighted, if it's that serious, you could be life flighted out, or they can sustain you until you go get to Chapel Hill if you need it, if it's severely. But the point is, you look and there was no plan. And so regardless of what they say, how their record, the record is speaking, the record showed plainly that you did not have a plan in place. And now, as you say, more jobs are at stake, because if these elderly are in these senior retired living facilities can't get to a hospital, then they got to get closer to where a hospital is. And you made it right. You hit it on the head. And so it's time for the listeners and time for the voters and the citizens of Franklin County to support people like you and others. Get a new sense of direction, a new type of attitude, and one that will work together with the citizen.
Yes, yes, yes. And we are so amazed with so many of our citizens that coming aboard and come around and talking to us and let us know that they are concerned. And I know everyone concerned, so many concerned about this. And so, but you can't fix it. You can't fix it. I mean, all we can fix it is now is to go to the poll. Just go to the poll, and don't, you can't worry about your record anymore. The record now speaks for itself. So let's go to the poll and just redo a new record. Because right now, we are waiting. We are trying to put forth a means so that we can get something going back in Lewisburg and the surrounding area. Because there's so much that can be done here in the city. And we're just waiting for it, because right now, it's nothing that no one is doing to after March the 15th. And yeah, I could say, if you want the same old result, and then, well, just vote the same old way. But if you want a new direction, and then we want you to go into the poll and vote a new way. And my name is on the ballot. It's Johnny Clifton Sr., and I need that vote. Make sure you go to your ballot, check that ballot. Johnny Clifton Sr., we need that vote so that we can kind of move forward. We also need Ginger. We need Ginger Baker. So we need her. So we need a change, but we cannot do it. And I speak very, very clearly to each and every one. I love to have the vote so I can get in. I love for Ginger to be in, but, you know, you just can't do it by yourself. And right now, we got, I'm quite sure the county commission got their committee. But the committee down there, we need work. People don't understand. You got to work. You got to work from the ground floor. There's no way we can start at the top now and build anything. You got to start on the ground floor. And this is your ground floor. On March the 15th, your ground floor work will start. And we want to start with a new opportunity. We want to start with a new direction. So make sure from March the 3rd through March the 12th is the early voting. March the 15th is the deadline. So be sure that you get your friends. Get them out to the poll. If they need a ride, Brother Atkins can call him at the station and call me, call him, my campaign. We'll be more than able to go out. We are ready to get you to the poll so we can start on the ground floor on March the 15th. March 16th, we want to be ready to roll.
That's right, and we're supporting you all the way because we believe that change is good. We believe in that people should have an opportunity. Everybody should have an opportunity. We've already seen what's been done thus far. We're if you're tired of the same things, if you know that we need jobs, you know we need a healthcare facility, you know that your voice matter and you have something to say about your community. If you care about your community, if you care about the growth of your community, then go out and vote March 3rd and 15th. Don't wait till too late. Go ahead on and vote Mr. Johnny Clifton Sr. Bubble him in and let us put Ginger. Let's get Ginger on board. Hopefully we're gonna get to have her on the show. I'm gonna reach out to her and see if we can have her come on the show and talk to listeners as well, because we need a change in Franklin County, and it starts with us at the poll. That's one of your voices right there. And if you don't feel like you have a voice, then you settle for the same old thing and don't complain about, you know, we need business in District 1, we need people, we need this and that. Don't complain about it when you don't go out and vote. Or if you settle and vote for the same old thing when you ride around town and you see nothing has changed too much, then you keep voting the same way. But don't complain about it at home. I shoulda, coulda. It's time to make a difference now, and it's time to start on the ground, on ground level zero, and let us build together something different. Let's take out the deal away with the old stuff, and let us get some new stuff, because let us have something for our young kids that are coming up. Let's build something for them. Let's build a better, safer community. And I believe Johnny and Ginger is one of those two people, along with others, that will be the next county commissioner, District 1. And brother, thank you again. Anything you want to say before we get off?
Well, Brother Mayor, I just want to thank you once again. And I hope that when I come back on the 16th, maybe after the 16th, we will come back with a victory. I'm looking for a victory. I'm not looking for nothing but a victory. Nothing to lose. I just got to win. So I'm looking for each and every one to go out to the poll and please, sir, and please, ma'am, think about the elders. Think about the children. Think about the future, because that our school, we need work in our school. We need everything that, we're just on the ground floor everywhere on all levels. So, need a change, and we are waiting for that change. So if you would, just go out and vote, and I'll be getting to come back. I'm coming back home and with a victory in time.
That's right.
After the 15 years, you don't know you're sitting here. And like I said, once again, it's Johnny Clifton Sr., for District 1, and Ms. Junior Baker for at large.
That's right. We're voting for you, man. We're voting for a change in the area. Once again, I want to thank you for coming on. And we're going to count victory already. We're going to say we already. Next commissioner, District 1, Mr. Johnny Clifton Sr. and Ginger Baker at large. So we want to thank all the listeners again. And we're going to continue the show. And we're looking to have him back on after the 16th to tell us the wonderful news and then the change. You got to get excited about it now. I'm already excited about it, so we got to get excited about it.
Yes, Lord.
Mr. Johnny, thank you so much for being on tonight, taking the time out to talk to the listeners about the change that needs to happen in the Franklin County area.
Thank you so much. Have a blessed night.
You too. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Never found what you're July's 12, bouncing through bars. Take a deep breath of the paint, the smog, the clouds and exhaust. So keep the chain swinging, bat against your palm. Take the road less compatible, then cram it in a song. Cause they're not gonna pay, stay rocking pockets of change. But knowing to call the game, cause bathroom floors are all the same. And it ain't glamorous to play the Saint, the Sinner and the Lazarus. Sometimes leave that passion in the kitchen drawer where the matches is. Your friends will die and take their lives and overdose. And when you see a dysfunctional family once a year, just hold them close. Cause you're a fighter, at least you still say that in your head. And yes, sentence, you guessed it, you still stress to pay the rent. But it's all peace, you packed up your girl and moved out east. And every day you either write or work on 4 hours of sleep. You've been all over the country making music with your friends. So keep doing what you're doing, cause I do it all again.
Right, think about it. Think about change in your community. Think about what it's going to take for us to have change in the community. And that's fresh faces, fresh bodies, and eager people that's going to work with us and going to treat us the same, regardless if you have a $200,000, $300,000, or you have a $500,000 home, or you renting. That's what we're talking about. Everybody together. And so, again, we want to thank Mr. Clifton for taking the time out, talking to us about the campaign. And like you said, you continue to vote the same way, you get the same result. Now, when the first election, you thought things was going to be changing, and then the next time the election came, you see that it pretty much everything stayed the same. Then the next election came and you see, okay, now people are talking about it. I see people on my Facebook feed all the time talking about how they need change, how they want change. Well, the change start when you go into the poll booth and you go in there and vote for somebody different than one that's already been doing and ain't doing, you know, in the same old results, same old thing. Now, granted, you know, things may have been done. I mean, you know, I'm not going to say things was total flop, but here lately, as you know, what have you done lately? What have you done for the citizens when we need, you know, voices are crying out? But where were your strategy plan? And why I can't understand for the life of me, why don't a leader want to go out and find corporations that will say that may need land to build warehouses or hubs or factories? You know, what about those places? What about some of our officials going to IBM? What about some of our officials calling up Amazon? Why don't some of our officials email or call up Sony? Because you know what? Cell phones are not going anywhere anytime soon. Devices are not going away soon. So they need people to put together these devices, connect these pieces, and therefore people have jobs. You know, granted, we are thankful to have restaurants that hire people to work. But when you're trying to grow, you know, restaurants are good, but you might want something better. And then therefore, when you want something better, you got to leave out of Lewisburg, out of Franklin County, to go to another area, Raleigh, Durham, Cary, for jobs. You know, you're looking at Bun. You're looking at Lewisburg, Franklinton, Centerville, Youngsville, all of these surrounding little towns that's within Franklin County, Pilot, all these little places. If you had two nice factories or warehouse where people can get jobs, then people are gonna feel great about themselves because they are making some money. You know, and you know, they're able to maybe move from renting to purchasing a home. But you know, so why don't they want to go out and look at these companies? Well, as I stated before, I talked to someone at the city, and the county, and I was told that it's not their job to go out and look for companies to come here. If the companies want to come here, then they seek them out. Well, if I'm in a position, if I'm a mayor and I see that my community is crying out that they need jobs, then I need to put my best foot forward and at least attempt to talk to these companies like Sony and Amazon and you know, IBM, all of these different companies, Hewlett Packard, and say, look, we got some land, and if you build, we could give you tax cuts. We could give you some incentive for bringing businesses here. And then, but first you gotta in-house hire. You know, just like the foreign country that company here that took over Han. You know, that one of the things was that they supposed to hire within the county. But they I don't think they held up to the agreement, but you know, but this is what we should do. So we thank Mr. Johnny Clifton for being on the air tonight, and as he mentioned, he's mentioned Baker, and so we want to try to maybe possibly reach out to her and see if her schedule is available. Shelley won't be on the show tonight. I was hoping to have her to give her a conversation about what her ideas were, but she won't be on the show tonight. And so we'll go down and whoever's available that wants change in the community and that want your vote, those that listening to this broadcast, then you find time to come on. And Ginger Baker, we're gonna try to get her on, and we want to again thank Johnny Clifton, and we're going to continue the best gospel praise talk show in America, the TMA Radio Show.
yes, you did. Oh, I gotta praise his name. Over 2,000 years ago, he came, bled, suffered, and died.
He did it all.
David Lyon has a sacrifice, and I gotta praise his name.
I made it through,
and so.
All right, your weather forecast tonight. We're looking at mostly clear, high, low of 32. Friday, mostly clear, high of 49 with a low of 27. Saturday, high of 51 with a low of 33. That's your 2.5 forecast. All right. We're going to be thanking God tonight for you listeners. And we're thanking God for breakthroughs all across the country. And we want to thank God for those that gave their life, those that gave their life to Him, that know that they wanted to turn around, and they allowed God to come in and turn around for them. We thank you. Tell somebody we're on every week, starting with Sunday to Thursday. So Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we are on. And sometimes when you're not doing something, find out what your community need and let's join together and work at it together. You know, we can't do it all by ourselves, but together we can do it one each by each. And so we need each other. We need to continue to improve on things in the community, and we can do it with each other. We it's hard to do it by myself. It's hard to do it by yourself. But together we can do it, and we can move mountains, and we can grow and live in peace and harmony. And that's the way God wanted us to live, in peace and harmony, and to have everything that we desire. And God bless us so much, amen, with family. And look at our children. If you have children, just take a look at them. You know, don't you want some nice things for your child's future? Don't you want to set something in place for that child? You know, we're supposed to leave an inheritance. That's why I do the things that I do, because my son may grab hold to entrepreneurship, and he might want to be an entrepreneur one day. He might want to have his own Fortune 500 company. Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Hey, speak those things into existence in your child's life. They can be whatever they desire, because God gives all of us talents and abilities to do many different things. Some have multiple talents, and I just thank God for the talents that He's given me. And so we just want to let you know that we're here for you, and we're here to pray with you. If you need prayer, you can call up the prayer line, 919-526-4916. And if you want to call up the show live, 919-521-4741. Again, that's 919-521-4741. Also, you can email ministeracrishow@gmail.com. We need listening partners here on the TMA Radio Show, where we can continue to share the good news of Jesus and share free salvation to the world. And it do cost for the radio station. And we want to also be a helping hand to those in need. We have families time to time call us up, and we want to be able to help them. But it takes you and I coming together, putting our resources together, our finances, to bless somebody else. So with that, if you want to be a blessing to the TMA Radio Show, email ministeracrishow@gmail.com and let us know. Say, hey, I want to donate to this show, this online ministry, and we'll help families as they call with their situation. And so I don't have nothing else to say but to thank God, the Most High God, that gives us grace and mercy. And we want to let you know that God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Turn it around today. Don't give up. Don't give in. You can make it. And also, go and vote. I want you to go and vote. We need you to go and vote, because your vote says something. And that's what we want to do. We want to make a change. We want to make a difference. And we want to put some different people in. This last song is dedicated to all of the mothers sitting out in listening land, those that are listening to this broadcast, all our grandmas, all of your mother's mothers if they're living, all of the great grandmas or mama, as you say. This song goes out to mama or whatever you call granny, nana, All right, this song, I Am Not Tired Yet. And we want to thank you and tune in Sunday night between 7 and 8 p.m. We start the beginning of the week for the TMA Radio Show. And enjoy your weekend. Be safe. And tell somebody you love them. Help your neighbor out if you, when you can and if you're healthy. And also, let's pray one for another that our strength in the Lord continue. In Jesus' name, amen.